Sadguru Brahma Sanatan He Sadguru Brahma Sanatan He Paramadaya Ghan Pavan He Paramadaya Ghan Pavan He Janmaj Dukh Vinashan He Janmaj Dukh Vinashan He
If you don't do not follow English, raise your hands.
If there
is no translation, Sarva will give you more time to talk to us. That's why. I hope all of you can understand English, right? Very good. Yeah. If Kerala does not understand, which state can understand? Because the state records highest rate of literacy. So you are always outstanding in your knowledge as well as in the awards and the rewards that your state gets quite often. I returned this morning after visiting East Godavari and West Godavari districts. A responsibility I have taken upon myself on my own. I am not delegated. I am not ordered, I am not commanded, much less authorized to do so. It is only at my own, some say at risk, for my own self-satisfaction, I have ventured to take this project. After Bhagavan left physically, there is a lacuna, there is a vacuum, and people everywhere are crying and crying, missing somebody so dear and near, more than one's own parent. They are feeling a great agonizing moments now. And to be honest, the Telugu media, newspapers and channels did worst damage to the organization and to Sai movement. That's really frustrating, disappointing, disheartening and depressing. Because all papers have written nuisance every day, all channels. Therefore, all the devotees' minds are full of this stuff. They have not lost their faith, but they are crying. Somebody to reply, somebody to answer them. They are in confusion because of so many things that they have come across while watching TV or reading newspapers. 100% damage is done to the Andhra Pradesh, 100%. If anyone does not agree with me, I pity his innocence or ignorance. 100%. Other than Andhra Pradesh, there may be about 40 or 50% damage. In North India, less, 25%. In foreign countries, 10%. Andhra Pradesh, 100%. Why, what, I don't go into the details. One reason is communication gap. Communication gap. And second reason is a kind of a situation that our people have not understood that we should rise to the occasion when we are to make an announcement, we should do it. When we are to announce, we should do it. When we are supposed to clarify, we should do it. So lack of communication, prolonged delay, these are all several of the factors responsible for the damage. Therefore, people, after all, there is nothing negative anywhere. People are anxious to know what happened. And when you don't say that, people will begin to suspect it. When they suspect, there will be allegations. All this stuff into the head naturally leads to confusion. It was, Bhagavan was in the hospital for 27 days. One question I got all over from everybody is this: He is God, why should He be there in the hospital for 27 days? This is a question. You cannot say He is God but still in the hospital. You cannot say that. And you cannot say, don't ask that question. You cannot say that. So we must answer them. We must answer them. Answer for the general public. Because we spoke about Swami, about His divinity, about His programs, about His message and mission. If we fail to answer these things, all the work we did so long loses its credibility, accountability, authenticity, if we do not answer them. So the question is, why should God be in the hospital for 27 days. If the answers I give are satisfactory to you, you can transmit, transfer and transform people later, if it is acceptable. Or you can tell on my face that I am wrong. I take with equal pleasure. Yes, I am sure. My answer to this question is this. Baba was there in the hospital for 27 days to prepare all the devotees to receive this shock, to receive this news which is unthinkable, undreamt. People are not prepared to accept it. People are not prepared to receive it. And Swami, had he withdrawn beforehand, 15 days or 10 days before, thousands would have committed suicide. Would have lost people in thousands of number, all over the world. How do I say that? In Prashanti Nilayam, many retired people are living because of Swami. And in Prashanti Nilayam, they're just people are staying singles. A widow or a widower or somebody whose grandson is studying in the school. There are old people are here with arthritis, spondylitis, totally dependent on Swami. What will happen to them? What will happen to these old people, those who are all alone? Then there's so many vegetable vendors, fruit wallahs, so many juice people, so many people outside, street hawkers, number of them are there. What will happen to them if they get this news all of a sudden? All over the globe it will shake, it will create tremors among the people. Therefore, one reason I think is preparation for the devotees to receive the shock, not leading to acts like suicide or anything like that. One should be courageous enough to receive this shocking news. That may be one reason. The second reason I think is this. Being with him quite near for 22 years, I have occasion to touch his feet, to do pada seva, press his feet, number of times. I am telling you, please, it must have been experience of some of our seniors also. His body is very soft, like cotton, very soft like silk, very soft like makhmal, very soft, tender, delicate body, Swami's body. For 27 days, how am I to believe that he just allowed the injections to be given, that his body could withstand intravenous injections, intramuscular injections, ventilators, dialysis, all these things that we hear in the newspapers? How could the body withstand that kind of severe treatment? To my knowledge, I don't think that his body can withstand that severe treatment. No, it cannot, because he is so delicate. So my understanding is, he has given his body to the care of doctors to do whatever they want, while he left the body moving around the devotees, visiting the devotees all over the world. Baba is busy beyond the body. If he is in the body, he cannot withstand that painful, tortuous treatment. he must have left the body to the care of doctors. You treat in the way you deem fit. And he must have been going around all over the world, visiting devotees, talking to devotees, guiding them. That could be the second reason. Or else he cannot stand. And third point is this. Nobody can force Swami to do anything. We cannot force him to take one spoon extra ragi food. Extra ragi, made up of ragi. We can't make him take one extra spoon of sweet or anything. Impossible. If he likes, he will take it. Or else not. Let him be the President of India or Queen of England. Nobody can force him. Nobody can force him to take a medicine. Impossible. Therefore, what happened was, he allowed the doctors to do whatever they can, whatever they feel fit enough, whatever their medical sciences suggest, remedial measures or curative measures, let them do whatever they like. But he left at a time when he wanted. He left at a time when he decided that doctors cannot help it. Doctors cannot prolong his life. No. He decided to withdraw and he has withdrawn. So the end has come as per his will only. Supporting statement to what I said was, Doctors International, Doctors National, doctors sent by the government of Andhra Pradesh also examined and they said, best treatment on earth is given to Sat Sai Baba. There is no higher level anywhere all over the world. Then why should he leave? He has decided to leave. Why should he leave? He has decided to come. So he has got every right to leave. The one who has come on his own can also go on his own, go back. Whereas you and I have not come on our own. And we cannot go back also on our own. We have come because of our karma, bank account. Until all that karma is exhausted, our karma mochanam, until all that karma is exhausted, we cannot leave this world. So our coming and leaving are not in our hands. It is bound by karmic effects, cause and effect. But in the case of avatar, his coming and withdrawal happen as per his will, as per his decision. When he wants, he'll come. When he does not, he'll go back. That's all. He has got nothing to do with karma. No. Why do I say that? Why do I say that? I'm also a student of science. I'm not here to tell you cock and bull stories. No. Supposing if any person left us, some Rao, he is no more. Call him Rao, Rao, Rao. He is not available. He must have taken some other birth somewhere. Rama, Rama, he is not with us. But still call Rama, he will answer your prayers. He will appear in front of you. Krishna is no more physically, but he will appear, he will answer your prayers. Why? Because avatars neither come nor go. They are ever existent. They are ever present. These are the answers I have given for that question. Why God should be in hospital for 27 days? That's one question. Then the second question was, is it true that good treatment is not given to Baba? it is a silly question. Not even good question, treatment. Best treatment is given to Baba. Of international standards. To say the treatment is not given properly means ignorance, they do not know. And the third question, is there any legal hire, something like deputy Baba? Because in Shankar Pitha, Kanchi Pitha, the successor is named, the second man to take over. Has Baba left any successor behind him? Is there any legal hire to succeed him? This is a question put to me. I said, these pithas, pithadipati, Kanchi, Sringeri, these are all pithas. And the heads of these pithas are gurus. Every guru will have shishya, who will be guru next time. But God is only one. How can he be deputy God, vice president God, super president God, deputy God or joint God? God is only one. There is no deputy God here. Therefore, God has no successors. He has no successors. He has no predecessors. Who is senior Baba? Who is junior Baba? Something like George VI, George VII, Elizabeth XV. There is nothing like that. God is only one. Then, now and forever. So there is no legal hire, there is no successor to Baba. That is the question put to me. Has he left any successor behind? No successor. But if he still force me to say, all Sai devotees are his successors. All Sai devotees all over the world are his successors. Then how about other people? Everybody on earth, devotees, non-devotees, animals and plants, all are legal hires, are successors of Baba. Why? Mama Ivamso Jiva Loke Jiva Deva Sanatanaha. The whole world, everyone is my spark, says Krishna in Gita. You are my spark. Understand that. Then who is the successor? Who are the legal heirs? All of us. That was my answer. Then came another question. When is Baba going to come back? I said, why do you ask that question? Sir, somebody think that he'll come back in 14 days. Somebody think that he'll come back after 1 year. When is he going to come back? That is the question put to me. My answer, he has not gone anywhere to come back. Since I have come here, I can go back. But he has not come anywhere. So there is nothing like going back. Why? He is everywhere. When he is everywhere, nothing like coming and nothing like going. When does he come back? My answer is, he has not gone. He has not gone away. He has not gone anywhere to come back. That is my answer. Then another question. Will all the activities continue as before after Swami left his body? Will all the activities will continue or not? I said, activities not only continue, it will be doubled and tripled and multiples. Why? Why? Baba is not the physical body. Then who is he? His energy. Who is he? Your indweller. Who is he? The one who encourages you. The one who gives you that creativity, that thought within you. The indweller. So activities not only continue, also be doubled, tripled in multiples. Because he is energy, Baba is energy. How can I say that? He himself has given an example. This bulb is giving us light. Supposing the filament is burnt, then bulb is useless, right? Whether bulb is burning or bulb is useless, but current is there. Supposing you remove the bulb, is there current or not? Current is there. So whether the bulb is here or not, but current is there. So Baba is here with the body, or he may not be in the body, but he continues like electricity. Understood? For children I am telling, he is always there. So there is nothing like activities being what you call being on the decline, nothing like that. We don't have to doubt about it. And then the next question, what was the last message of Baba? What was the last message of Baba? I said, God has no first message and last message. His message is message. And that message is eternal. That message is continuous. Bhagavad Gita is the first message or the last message? Immortal message. Eternal message. Bhagavad Gita is not last message. It is a message forever and ever. So what is Baba's last message? His last message is the first message. First message is the last message. It is a message for every day, for centuries to come. What is that message? Tell me in one sentence. What is the message of Baba? Tell me in one sentence. What he said was, love is God, God is love. So that love is God, God is love. That is the message of Baba, which will continue so long moon and sunshine. Then comes another question. People are speaking so many things about him. All people must be knowing that. As people are think of money, people speak of some gold and all those things. These things appeared in the papers. What do you say about it? I told them, Baba has nothing to do with money. I never saw Swami holding currency note. I never saw him. I never saw Swami checking the accounts book. Swami has no passbook. Swami has no account in State Bank or any other bank. He has no account on his name in any bank. I never saw him asking for accounts or counting money. Nothing, I never saw him. All these 22 years being so near him. He never touches anything. He has nothing to do with money. Nothing to do with money. All the money that has come there, maybe out of prayers, out of requests, or out of force, or out of, sent by courier, or something like that. But he never bothers. Please believe me, there will be many, many checks, I am sure, which must have been lapsed by this time. The date of expiry, lapse, last date, also must have gone. Because he never cares to see any checks. He never cares to see any amount or any money. Baba has nothing to do with the money. Then obviously these things happen. How do you find these things happening? Because people credit the amount to the trust through a bank. And that amount is used, which is audited thoroughly. Why do you say that? How do you say that? Because media people won't leave you. I say that because the central government and the state governments waived so many exemptions to our hospitals and education institutions. We have no sales tax, we have no commercial tax, nothing like that. All exemptions are given. Why? They are all welfare projects. Why? All people know that not even one single paisa will be misspent here only in such an organization. Then there is somebody who asked me, how do you say that money will not be mismanaged? That there won't be mismanagement of money. How do you say that? Simple. No check is honored unless there are two signatures. There should be two signatures on every check. Then only the check is honored. Then how do you expect any misappropriation here? Not only that, simple example. Then I was the principal in Bangalore College for 6 years. Supposing college budget 2 lakhs, simple example. 2 lakhs for college budget. They don't give you all the 2 lakhs. No. They send you 10,000 first. You send the receipts. They'll check all the vouchers receipts. Then release next 10,000. There in the receipts, you cannot have any bill for refreshments. I served coffee to staff members, staff faculty. So 50 rupees, nothing doing. I went to the city on office work. You cannot claim any bus charge also. You cannot charge anything other than 100% college academic work. No refreshments, no travel, nothing. If they are satisfied with their vouchers, then they will release next 10,000. Well, no, impossible. Even if you want to misappropriate, not possible. Because they will check every installment and release the next one. There is no possibility. Then the question I got, another question I got was, when will Prema Sai come? What do you say about Prema Sai? I said 2 things. First of all, I am not interested in Prema Sai personally. Why? He is not here right now. When he comes, I do not know whether he will be alive or not. When I come back because of rebirth, I may be a Naxalite or a CPM or Bodoland or Punjab terrorist, why not? Where is the guarantee that we Baba's devotee? Where is the guarantee that I recognize him? Where is the guarantee that he will recognize me? So thinking of Prema Sai is out of question because it is futuristic. There is a future. We cannot say anything. So what shall we do? This Sai is enough. Think of this Sai. Serve this Sai. Listen to his message. That is enough. You don't have to think of Prema Sai. The fellow who is not benefited by this Sai, do you think that he is going to be benefited by next Sai? Impossible. Why? How do I say that? I am putting these questions so people, you may ask me or you may not ask me because of my acquaintance, because of your love for me. You may not ask me. So I myself asking on your behalf and replying. Once it happened, the Tamil Nadu state president, I think, T.G. Krishnamurti, Here in Sai Kulwant Hall, in his welcome address, he said, Baba, we want to serve you till the last breath. We want to be in your company till the last breath. We would like to serve Prema Sai also. Then Baba gave his lecture. Where is the guarantee that you will come back with Prema Sai? Where is the guarantee that you will come to know him? It is enough if you serve this Sai. It is enough if you understand this Sai. That's Baba's reply. Baba's reply, which is really amazing, really amazing. Next question. These are all the questions put to me by journalists, TV channels, and these answers I gave them on my own, which is very risky. Here nobody will do it. But I didn't care, I don't care. What is it? What is it I'm going to lose? I cannot allow people to speak ill of Swami. I cannot allow people speaking ill of Swami. No. So I'll go and attack. Come on. If anybody says no, I'll say equally no to him. Yes. What is it? All prospects on this planet are over. Any more prospects in the other planet awaiting. So we need interplanetary travel or intergalactical travel. No. If anybody speaks bad of my father, do I need your permission? No. Then Mata Pita Gurudaya Mariyamta Inine. But you want somebody's permission. There's nothing but call gas. I cannot accept that. So I went voluntarily all myself and started answering the media question after question, repeatedly. Then they asked me, what is the immediate effect on Prashanti Nilayam in the light of Swami's withdrawal, physical withdrawal? We should not say die like that. Withdrawal. We die. They withdraw from the body. That's wrong usage to say Baba died. No. He's birthless, deathless, eternal. He withdraws and he can come back. So withdrawal of the body, what is the immediate effect on Prashanti Nilayam? That is the question put to me. There is no effect. Why? Nagar Sankirtan is going on. Bhajans are going on. People are still staying. Nobody left. And on the other hand, the Samadhi there, built in white stone, the whole Samadhi, white marble, and it has got gold color edge, border, gold color border. Have you not seen? That is the convocation or birthday dress of Baba. Convocation or birthday dress of Baba is white dress with gold border. So what is Samadhi now? Samadhi is the resting place of Baba. Samadhi is the place where he is resting to see his children. That is the answer I gave. Because 23rd, he left 25th, it was on 27th, the Samadhi. But what will happen to 2 days, 3 days? Should I go and sit and cry like that? How about others who are not here? Then I came out, I saw all the channels and newspapers fellows, come on, ask me, I'll tell you, on my own. And on 27th, when Samadhi program was going on here, I found some VIPs, Prime Minister, President, they're all here, Cabinet Ministers. And only one announcement. What is it? There will be Sarvadharma prayer. That's all. No other work. Shall I sit there? Sitting idle. How about lakhs of devotees outside, all over the world? Then I just came out. Call those TV fellows. Now you understand this. When Prime Minister, President leaves us, there will be a big procession. There will be a commentary. The gun carriage is going, passing by Mughal Gardens. The gun carriage passing by the India Gate. They give running commentary when Rashtrapati or somebody leaves us. But when Vishwapati withdraws his body, what should we do? Shall I keep quiet, keep my mouth shut? Impossible. I thought Vishwapati also needs some commentary. So the whole world will know what is going on here. I told them, immediately they made arrangements. One TV, I will be seeing what all that is going on here. And then another TV, where I will be speaking the running commentary as in New Delhi. Believe me or not, brothers and sisters, young children, the effect of these talks, the effect of these interviews given to different channels and newspapers have consoled lakhs of devotees all over Andhra Pradesh, have given strength to many, many, many devotees all over the world. I have my children in US. They rang up and told me, because our time zones are different. The American time, our times are different. But they kept huge screens in all science centers all over America and projected the whole of the TV channels where I was interviewed. Though it is in Telugu, most of the foreigners are non-Telugu people. Say Latin America, Mexico, they don't know English anything. But all those people were watching that until 4 o'clock next morning. Throughout night, they'll catch some Telugu speaking fellow, get some translation, watching that throughout till 4 o'clock next morning. And these people are wondering what kind of devotion they have, what kind of interest they have to know about Swami. So my friends, what I want to sum up is, there are certain things where we cannot go by simply by command or by dictation or by any GO, government orders. No, no. Some house is burning here. Shall I wait orders from Panchayati president? When house is burning, go there, don't wait for orders. That's what I felt and started doing that work, which gave me immense satisfaction, a feeling that I have expressed gratitude to my God, Bhagwan Sri Sat Sai Baba. Some gratitude. I cannot pay gratitude commensurate with the blessings conferred upon me. Impossible. Just little service. Rather simply lying at home, I want to do it. As the days passed by, suddenly another thought came to me. All right, we are here, our devotees are there. I gave all my life for the organization. I swear in the name of God. All my life. I didn't know the birthdays of children, or wedding days, or days to dropping them at the airport, or follow them to drop them at their in-laws residence. I never did anything of that kind. Organization, throughout my life. And another idea came to me. At this moment, what will happen to the organization? All the devotees will be crying there. There are nobody to go and talk to them. Nobody to tell them. Nobody to encourage them. But we send the circulars. Please send your monthly report. Send your quarterly report. Send your Sevadal report. Hare, hare. What is it that you do? Then I thought, nonsense, stop it. I was feeling very bad. Then I told East Godavari people, Arayil, now I'll be visiting you. Come on, I'll start with East Godavari. Then I visited that. That triggered West Godavari. Then said, Saravotas, come on, I'll come to you. And somebody asked me, have you taken permission? I'll take permission to get out of this place, okay? You can inquire at the college. The whole syllabus is covered. All question papers are set. Evaluation is regularly going on as per the schedule. Then why can't I do rest of the period? This service. So I'm doing it. If you say, oh, you can't go, you can't do, thank you. I'll go elsewhere and do it. Baba is important to me. Because I'm here, I'm working in the university. I'm not here to work in the university. Since I'm here, I'm working there. I'm not here because of the work there, no. Baba is most important. And I cannot allow the Rome to be burned while Nero plays on his violin. We must do something for that. In East Godavari and West Godavari, believe me, every meeting attended by not less than East Godavari, not less than 8 to 10,000. All villagers, West Godavari, not less than 5 to 6,000. All those people, old devotees. There are devotees of Swami for 50 years, 40 years like that. Seniors, aged 70, 80, like that. They were all hugging me and crying, Anil Kumar, Swami, what shall we do? Why should we continue to live? Who should have left this body prior to this? What is it? So I had to go meet everybody, move among them, encourage them and assure them that Swami is in our midst. So my present activity is this, if you want to put it, spiritual rehabilitation. Very important. If we neglect this, we will never come back. Take it from me. When patient is running 105 temperature, you cannot say, I'll treat you next week. It will be too late. When this fire havoc, if we don't put off or extinguish the fire, we have to collect the ashes later. Now or never, that is the challenge. Therefore, my friends, we in the organization should be committed to the organization more than before. To be dedicated to the organization more in a more determined way. Do the work in a splendid way, more than ever before. I know the state president is here. I also see seniors here, belonging to the organization, who know me well, and I know them equally well. We love, respect, we have affection towards each other. With that, I can tell you, with that intimacy, I take the liberty to tell you my feeling from my heart. What is it? If we lose one Sai devotee in any Sai center, the office bearer is a sinner or a criminal. I am a sinner if I lose one member from the organization. I am a criminal if I lose one member. Spiritual criminal? Yes, if we do, you don't like the word criminal, let me see, organization criminal or a religious criminal. A decent caption. We should not lose a single devotee at any cost. Please go through the list every day. Silently observe the attendance in Sai Bhajan centers so that they all continue to have the same strength before. Retention, retaining people is most important now. Number two, encouraging people to visit Prashanti Nilayam in large numbers is very, very important. Nobody should say that Prashanti Nilayam is empty. Nobody should say that people are not coming in large number. It is a shame to all of us, God forbid, if that happens. It should not happen. We should encourage them to bring, to go over here. We can organize state Sevadal meetings, Balavikas Gurus conference, state conference, something or other here, so that people will start coming here. Because this is a place where my God lived. This is a place where our God moved. This is a place where our God consoled us, blessed us, so near, so dear to all of us. Who cared to collect letters from us? Who cared to find out how our families are, how our health is, how our children are doing? When he showered such a personal attention, personal love, that we could talk to him, give him a letter and a flower. Is it not our duty to see that this temple will maintain its that divine glory, that divine prestige? Is it not our duty to say that Swami will take care, Swami will take care? You are taking care of your breakfast. Swami is not taking care of your breakfast. There are some third class devotees, I tell you. Useless fellows, number one. Or we should do something. Swami knows better. You don't know anything at all. If Swami knows better, why should you have your lunch? When Swami does everything, why should you have your breakfast? Yes. We are taking care of our personal things. We are taking care of professional things. Bank rates, interest rates, bullion market. But Swami's activity, Swami knows, Swami knows. He will take care of the third-rate philosophers. Atheists are better than these third-rate philosophers. How really, my friends, if we are like this, it is because of Satya Sai Baba. Our name, our fame, our wealth, our health, reputation, everything today, children, grandchildren, progress, everything is because of Baba, believe me or not. How about those people of our age outside who are not Baba's devotees? Take any fellow. If you are 70, take another fellow 70 years outside. If you are 60, think of another fellow of your age outside. What are they doing? Going around doctors. BP problems, sugar problems, family problems, financial problems. Problems, problems, problems. But how about our Sai devotees? In spite of problems, in the midst of problems, we are happy because of Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba. We still continue to smile in the midst of problems. He gave us technique to be happy. He gave us, he taught us a mechanism to be happy. What should we do in return? All of us, all those who have seen Swami physically, will agree with me if I say, with the skin, even if we make pair of sandals to Baba, slippers to Baba, with our own skin, it is not enough of expression of gratitude to Swami for all that we have received, for all that we have received. Number four, we should take care of two important aspects now. Brother Mukundan, I beg your pardon if I am stretching far, because we are all comrades in distress. That's what I am feeling. What should we do now? Two things are important. Love among ourselves. We should love each other. There should not be any difference of opinion. There should not be any disunity. There should not be any rumor mongering. There should not be any scandals. There should not be any backbiting. There should not be any petitions, letters written. That is all silly, utterly stupid activity. Not even gentlemanly. A gentleman won't write petitions like that. Only timid fellows write like that. If you got guts, come on. Stand and ask. That too now, when Swami is not amidst us, if we fight on silly grounds, if we have differences, now we are worst people on earth. We are doing worst damage to such a high moment. Therefore, brothers and sisters, let us forget all the differences. Let us forgive all those people who are negative to us, who are against us. Let us forgive them. Let us forget our differences, because it's high time, because time is up. 4 months over. How long you want to continue this? So love, unconditional love. You may be wrong, and because you are wrong, we are not together now. You may be wrong, still I love you. I may be wrong, still you love me. That love is neither right nor wrong. Love is love. Love is God. God is love. Love amongst us should be demonstrated unconditionally by forgiving and forgetting. Love should be there, clearly established by compromise. By compromise. Sometimes I may feel insulted, I may feel humiliated, does not matter, I compromise. Still, for the sake of my God, I'll bear all my insults. For the sake of my God, I'll bear all my humiliations, utter neglect, whatever it may do, because of my God. That's the reason why Holy Bible says, blessed are those who are punished. Because they are punished, since they are close to me, so I bless them. They are criticized because they are close to me, I will bless them. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the kingdom of heaven. Let us bear the cross of blasphemy. Let us bear the cross of criticism, mudslinging, backbiting, character assassination. So, brothers, love should be exhibited in our unity. You can say, I love you. How about unity? When there is no unity means there is no love. I cannot tell my son, I love you, my son. He'll say, how much property you are going to give me? Therefore, love is our strength. Love is unity. Love is divine. Love is forgetfulness. And love is forgiveness. Love is tolerance. Love is patience. And that love is God. And that God is our Satya Sai Baba. This is the fundamental thing. I repeat any number of times, whether people listen to me, agree with me or not, nobody can silence my voice. Love. And the next thing, devotion to Baba. Bhakti. Prema among ourselves, bhakti towards Baba. Some people say, I have bhakti. No. Why? If you really have bhakti, have you sacrificed your time for the organization? Have you sacrificed your money for the organization? Have you sacrificed your talent for Sai mission? Then what do you mean by bhakti? What do you mean by that? Bhakti means service. Bhakti is sacrifice. Come on, participate in Sai bhajans. Participate in Sai service activities. Do not leave the organization any time. There are some people who say, I am comfortable at home. He forgets the fact that it is totally wrong. Utter foolishness. If we are to leave Baba for any reason, it is the worst of the tragedies that can happen in our life. He has chosen us. He has encouraged us. He has loved us. He has brought us up. He made us what we are today. And if we are to leave, it is most unfortunate. Most unfortunate. So our devotion means unadulterated, unpolluted, concentrated, one-pointed attention on Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba. Because some people, I started going elsewhere. Elsewhere, what do you get? What is that you don't have here is not available anywhere. What is not available in Satya Sai is not available anywhere in the world, I bet. We read so many books, we met so many people, but Satya Sai Baba is a departmental store. You can have binge car in a departmental store. You can have toothpaste also available in a departmental store. Satya Sai Baba is a spiritual departmental store. He will give you whatever you like. Then why should you go elsewhere? It is not a fruit market. It is not general stores. It is a departmental stores. Everything is available. Therefore, my friends, let us not think of that most unpleasant moment when we have to leave our organization, our Swami, for any reason. Because supposing like this, costly necklace I bought, diamond necklace, 10 lakhs or so, out of my life earnings, I gave her one diamond necklace. Supposing she loses it, it is lost. What does it mean? My life savings are gone. Similarly, when we are to neglect organization, when we are to be indifferent to Sai movement, losing lifelong earnings, losing lifelong merit. Losing divine opportunity given to us. Our Swami, whether we know or not, how He has saved our children, how He has saved our lives, how many of elderly people in our own family who are to leave this world are brought back to life by Bhagavan. How many of us who had a very humble beginning and today we are something in society. We are nobody then. If I am to say about myself, I am only an Anil Kumar, college lecturer with 184 rupees salary. Why 94? And today, where has Swami taken me to? That is true with everybody. That is true with everybody, not only me. Everybody. I know a person who could not pay his house rent regularly. He started Sai Bhajans and he became an MLA, later Speaker of the Assembly. I know another fellow, another advocate, who was living in a tiled house, no practice, to maintain his family. He wanted to join as a clerk in a college. He started Sai Bhajans and today, couple of crores, same fellow was walking on the street. The one who gives you what you want, the one who gives you what you want, what you deserve, is only Bhagavan Sri Sat Sai Baba. Yes, I never wanted any money and therefore I am not bothered about it. I never cared for any position. I never cared about it. But I wanted to spread his message. That has been my lifelong ambition. And Baba granted that, which I have been doing relentlessly for the last 40 years. That's what I wanted, that's all. In fact, Baba asked me, tell me what you want. I said, I don't want. No, tell me what you want. Swami, I'm telling you I don't want. Why do you say that? Tell me what you want. Then I said, Swami, when God gives me without asking, what is there to ask for? Without asking, you are giving me. Why should I ask? No, don't speak philosophy. Tell me what you want. Before everybody. Then I said, I don't want Swami, please. Please leave me at this stage. Then he said, do you want moksha? Don't you want moksha? I said, I don't want. He said, why? All religious people of all religions want moksha. Why don't you want moksha? Why? Swami, I don't want. Why? I don't know whether moksha is sweet or hot. I don't know whether moksha is tall or short. I don't know whether moksha is beautiful or ugly. I don't know what it is. Nobody came and told me, Mr. Anil Kumar, moksha is beautiful. You also get it. Nobody asked me and told me that. But since you are insisting me to ask, now I am asking Swami. What is it? A chance to be born again and again and again, and chance to visit every doorstep, tap the door of every residence, travel worldwide and spread your message. That is my desire, nothing else, I said. I don't want anything else. Baba was so happy. Manchidi, 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 very good, he said it. Not to get that compliment, that is that. My life is like that. Therefore, my friends, as your brother, as a member of your own family, with all my love towards you, please see that we'll be strong, stronger and stronger. That we'll grow from strength to strength. And that Kerala state will maintain its glory, pristine glory, pristine purity. I tell everybody, you do not know, I tell everybody, every state president, I tell him, please go to Kerala and learn from them about service activities. What they are doing, learn. In one of the central council meetings, I said, how is that you invited these people who do not know anything about education? Where is the Kerala state president here? Why don't you bring people with some experience? I asked them there directly. Therefore, my friends, I have got a very, very high opinion about that state of Kerala, which is a fact. It's not a partial opinion or a dream, no, it's a fact. Never come here from that state. Good number of teachers come here. Very good number of youth come here. Different cross sections of public. And again, office wear and salon come here. They have orientation programs here. You are really of very high quality. Please see that it will never step down, come what may. We should pledge that our flag will fly high, because that's such a high flag. It's not a flag of your personal glorification. It is not a flag of flattery. It is not a flag of exaggeration. It is a flag of divine glory. It should fly high. For that, my friends, let me first congratulate you for organizing Onam for 4 days, for last 4 days. I saw the whole invitation. Patients, community advocates, teachers, different dates, having conferences. That made me feel very, very, very proud of my brethren from that state of Kerala. I pray from the bottom of my heart, Swami, please strengthen Kerala. Kindly bless those Malayalis. Please be with them forever and ever. And another fact, whether people accept or not, these Malayalis are spread all over the world. Today, maximum in Gulf countries. Very good number in US. And I met abroad. All of them are super intelligent fellows. Very, very intelligent people. I have not come across an average Malayali abroad. Very intelligent. Most sincere. Very hard-working, dependable, reliable. There's no backbiting, nothing like that. If they have come up in life, it is because of God's grace. God has special grace on Kerala. Please go back to Swami's discourses given to Malayalis on Onam Day. Please refer Swami's talks on occasions like this, Onam talk. Every talk, yes sir, he praises Kerala to skies. Am I not right? He says, it may be a communist land, but it is only political. All of them are religious. They may be political, but they are religious. The entire population of Kerala, there are deeply religious people. Deeply religious people. There are no atheists. The Guruvayur temple, how many large people it attracts? The Sabarimala? That's a place, that's a land of gods. You need fellows like me to praise you. You do not know how great you are. You do not know this. Indians are like that, hopeless buggers. We are like that. Foreigners come and say, yours is a great land. We say, is that so? Foreigners come and say, this is a holy land. I do not know. Foreigners come and learn yoga here. We have no yoga to learn yoga. They speak on Gita, they speak on Yoga Vasishta, we don't have anything. Therefore, my friends, avatar has taken birth in this country. Avatar has taken birth in this country. Why? Not to do anything new. Only to let you know how great you are. Only to let you know how fortunate you are. Only to let you know what a blessed land Bharat is. And in Bharat particularly, Swami's love for Kerala is amazing, fantastic. Please go through all talks that Bhagavan gave on Onam occasions. You'll be thrilled how he describes the land, how he describes temples, how he describes rituals. Actually speaking, this evening I wanted to speak on Onam and Swami's message, but he has taken charge and made me speak something different what I wanted. I accept it as his will, does not matter. What he said about Onam, you can read from the books. But this fits the present occasion, I believe. I thank Brother Mukundan for having invited me. I thank all my senior brothers who are seated in front. We exchange smiles every time. Wherever they sit, they give me nice smile and they cannot avoid me. I will not allow them to avoid me either. Yes. Because I believe me, I swear in the name of Baba, Baba devotees are more than my blood relations, are more than my blood relations. Such an organization is my life. These are very important. For that sake, I am ready to catch hold the feet of anybody. If it is not possible, I am ready to oppose anybody. Because organization and Baba are very, very important. Sai movement should continue for centuries to come. Future will not excuse us if we neglect our responsibility today. Future generations will curse us if we do not discharge our duty expected of us. Just as we hand over property to our children, we should hand over this spiritual treasure to the coming generations. May Baba be with you forever and ever. Thank you for your patient listening.
Before I say something, one of our beloved boys from Sri Shailam want to say something. He will come in first.
Om Sri Saya. First of all, I dedicate my loving pranams at the lotus feet of my beloved mother Saya. I thank Mukundan sir who really give me this ample opportunity which I can use to thank Ali Kumar sir. See, from the day I came to Prashanti Nilayam in the Kulwan Hall, I used to take my head up and search for sir. And this day, Bhagavan has blessed us with this valuable talk and his valuable presence. And really, I say, I am trembling with emotions and words are not enough to describe our gratitude to sir. And this is the soothing we really needed. Thank you, sir.
Your name?
Mohit.
Mohit. Abba, what class? Which class? Ninth. Are you very good?
Bhagavan was telling, sir, the number of people who have contributed different amounts of money to the hospital project. Sir became little unhappy because Swami asked him, why you were so unhappy? Anukumar sir told Bhagavan, Bhagavan, I didn't make any contribution. Then Bhagavan said, all those people have given me money, but you have given me your life. Understand the importance of that statement. All people have given you money, but you have given me your life. That is why, so from the bottom of his heart, sir was talking to us. What is the need of the hour? How we should respond to the situation? And what are the greater tasks before us so that this unique great organization will be stronger and stronger to be handed over to the next generation. So certainly we will rise to that occasion with the grace of Swami, no doubt out of it. Sir was very, 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 it is an in-depth discourse sir has given to us. And I think so many days to come we have to digest it. Think each and every word sir was telling us. But still sir, I request you sir to have a budget.
Thank you very much for information. We thank Mr. Satish there, who is taking video filming now, and you can have CDs from him on this talk. And very soon, you will have this on the website saiwisdom.com. saiwisdom.com is the website where you will have all your pictures and this talk covered over there. We thank Mr. Satish for sparing his time and for doing this wonderful job. And God bless you, Satish. Thank you very much. I never thought that I would be able to speak this much.
We all accompany you, sir.
Sir, out of order, sir, accompany.
We can understand because when sir was telling us, speaking to us, we can see that the voice is not in good condition. And the only reason is, when sir was going to his Godavari and West Godavari and speaking to thousands and thousands of devotees, naturally, this ought to be the condition. But sir, we are very happy that you spend about 1.5 hours with us, sir. We are so happy. And we take this as the real onam prasadam given by Bhagavan to Kerala organization.
Thank you very much. Happy Onam to everybody.
Thank you.